better to be back, according to my grandmother, rejoicing in the spirit world, away from all of this that we experience here, you know, in life. I know a place.
Ain't nobody
crying.
In 1971, Albertus Isbell, known professionally as Al Bell, had just been to the funeral of his murdered brother Louis.
Ain't nobody worried.
Thinking about his brother, Bell began to hear music.
Ain't no smiling face. Lying to the races.
A bass line.
Help me. Come on. Come
then words.
I'll take you there.
That became I'll Take You There, written and produced by Al Bell, recorded by the Staple Singers, and released by Stax Records. From humble beginnings in Brinkley, Arkansas, to his position as chairman of Stax Records and president of the Motown Records Group, Bell is recognized as one of the premier business executives in the history of the recording industry.
My father, who was a farmer, would go into Brinkley on Saturday night. And I got a chance back then to see Blind Lemon and Louis Jordan and all of them as 2, 3, and 4 years of age, and hear my father play his harmonica.
In the 1970s, two of the largest African-American-owned businesses in America were Motown Records and Stax Records. Bell joined Stax in 1965 as director of promotions. He quickly rose through the ranks of the company, becoming co-owner in 1969.
The thing that allowed me to turn it around was one great product, but I knew distribution and understood it completely. I knew marketing. I knew what to do in the marketplace, even though there were problems there where they wouldn't even carry black records. I knew how to get around that.
Al Bell became 100% owner of Stax in 1972. Helped shape careers, and produced gold and platinum hits with artists including Isaac Hayes, the Staple Singers, Otis Redding, Billy Eckstein, and the Dramatics, just to name a few.
You know, after Otis's plane crash, I was so into Otis, it took me, I don't know, maybe 10 to 15 years before I could even listen to an Otis Redding record. They all were my favorites. I was really a blessed guy.
Stax Records provided financing and marketing support on the release of Melvin Peebles' revolutionary film Sweetback, and with MGM on the release of Shaft. Bell added to the roster of box office hits through Stax Records' new film corporation, the landmark 1973 film Watt Stax, a documentary about the historic day-long concert featuring Stax artists that entertained 112,000 people in the Los Angeles Coliseum in response to the Watts Rebellion.
From the little girls, little boys, grandchildren, to the old children, and every segment of the African-American community there in peace and in harmony and enjoying themselves. That was my greatest moment.
In 1988, Bell became president of the Motown Records Group, where he worked with Berry Gordy on the sale of Motown to the MCA Boston Ventures Group.
It was quite an honor for me as a black man, and for two black men to work together like that. I think that was historical.
Following, Bell added tag teams Whoomp, There It Is, and Prince's The Most Beautiful Girl in the World to his already impressive production catalog. However, Bell is not done writing new chapters for his legend.
I want to build a global music entertainment industry in the state of Arkansas, based here in Central Arkansas.
Bell and his wife, Lydia, have been married for 51 years. They have two sons, Gregory and Jonathan, and two grandchildren, Colby and Dylan. Among his very long list of civic and professional honors, in 2011, Bell received the Grammy Trustees Award of the National Association of Recording Arts and Sciences for Lifetime Achievement.
That was the ultimate to have my industry say, we're going to give you this Grammy Trustee Award. That was my moment in my industry.
In Soulsville, USA, the Stax Records story, the Reverend Jesse Jackson says, Stax was not just a record company. It was a sound. It was a piece of culture. It was a moment of conscience and experience of mankind.
When I'm able to work with them and see them become what I have envisioned and what I see in them, that's the driving force that's in me. It's about humanity. It's about helping people. That's me.